not looking back at Charlotte Street, Supreme Court Building, Charlotte Street and Avenue of the Republic, looking south. Oh well, say hi.
Hello.
Say hi to my subscribers in New York and London and Toronto.
Hi.
What's your name?
Raquel.
Pardon?
Raquel.
Raquel, say hi to London.
Oh, hi London. Welcome to Guyana.
All right, and come back. Come back and visit us.
Oh, this is my day. I'm ready to take it on, come what may.
Border Market, and this is the Border Cemetery. So there's a cemetery here in the center of the city, very old cemetery, and it has been renovated recently. That's Regent Street on a Sunday afternoon. That's the Border Market. That's what's happening on Sunday afternoon. There's still some shopping and selling. And here is some new arrangement for stalls on the outside of the market. So there's still some shopping that goes on here on weekdays. These are stalls that have been constructed to extend the market. What we want to do is to continue our walk westward on Charlotte Street. So here we are back at Charlotte Street. What you will see is that as you go further westward, Charlotte Street becomes increasingly commercial. So this is a continuation of Charlotte Street westward. So it ended at Orange Walk, but now continues on the other side of the cemetery, and again it's commercial and residential. So as you can see, there are commercial property. Much more commercial property. There's still some residences, right? There's still some residential property. But there's mostly or a lot of commercial property. Yeah, yeah. That's looking back. That's me. So there is still some commercial and residential property on Charlotte Street. But as we head towards downtown, that is towards Republic, it becomes increasingly commercial. This is Alexander Street. This is Charlotte Street at the intersection of Alexander Street. There you go, Alexander Street. That's the Guyana Nurses Association. Just looking back at Charlotte Street. Here is a Brazilian restaurant and pizzeria. So there is an increasing presence of Brazilian businesses, and that Brazilian restaurant is an example. So here you have more commercial establishments on Charlotte Street. Hello.
Hi.
Where's Ashley? Where's Daddy? Is she going to church? Tell her hello. Hi. Bye. So, this is Charlotte Street. And that's another commercial building. More commercial buildings. So as we get closer to downtown, it becomes increasingly commercial. That's looking across towards Regent Street, that is looking north. And this is south. So there are residences mixed in with commercial property. But those of you who've known Charlotte Street for a long time would know that a lot of it has changed. So if you were around in the 1980s, this building was built back then. It used to be part of the WRSM. They had an America store here where you could shop with American dollars. Okay, that's a church on Camp Street. So the next section is Camp Street. Yes, as I was saying, this building used to be owned by the WRSM, eventually got purchased by Citizens Bank, the major beverage manufacturer in Diana that runs Citizens Camp Street. Right, so this is the used to be the Citizens Bank. But now Citizens Bank has built a new building. The building on Camp Street is now Citizens Bank. This building, also now empty, was a shoe store, commercial building. And here are other commercial buildings on Charlotte Street. And of course, residential, commercial and residential. So, Charlotte Street, as you get closer and closer to downtown, becomes increasingly commercial. Although there's still some residences mixed in. So, what is interesting in this block is that these tall buildings have also been constructed in the last 20 years and our expansion of wholesale and retail businesses onto Charlotte Street. Oh no, this is Rally Fashions, and the next block is a food manufacturer. So this is a factory building, and again, more commercial property. Okay, so what's going on here is a little bit of playing on the streets. As I said, what's interesting is that the corner of Wellington Street and Charlotte Street used to be this cinema, and it's now a church. So this is Jesus Christ is Lord, Universal Church of Kingdom of God. But it used to be a cinema. It used to be, I believe it used to be the Strand Cinema on Wellington Street. But Wellington Street looking north. That's Charlotte Street looking back east. That's Wellington Street looking south. This is a Toyota dealership in Guyana.
past the cinema that has been converted into a church.
So these two buildings are owned by Bihari Sons.
They are commercial buildings on Charlotte Street and across the street, of course, more commercial property.
So this is essentially the commercial part of Charlotte Street as we head towards downtown. It's almost exclusively commercial. Almost exclusively commercial. And rightly so, because it's now prime real estate. As you can see, a lot has changed in the downtown section of Charlotte Street because, of course,
expansion and demand. So this is looking at property, the back end of property on Regent Street from Charlotte Street. So a lot has changed in terms of demand, and so there has been escalating
renovation in terms of size of tall buildings being built in the downtown area because of demand for property. We approach the intersection with Charlotte Street and King Street. This is well-known Mirage building since 1966. It houses law offices and business offices. So what is new is this mall. It's actually been built within the last 5 years. Sharon's building at the corner of Charlotte King Street, that is Charlotte Street, at the corner of King Street, and this is in fact the Supreme Court complex. That's King Street looking south, that's the Mirage building, Charlotte Street looking back east. So as we approach the end of Charlotte Street, you can see this is the Supreme Court block and Sharon's Mall. Right, this is a new mall and commercial space that has been recently constructed, and again another commercial building. And the Supreme Court complex on the south side of Charlotte Street. This is the Supreme Court building. Again, you can see the old architecture, the old colonial architecture. It still shows that level of detail. It's rarely seen in modern buildings. But this is also on Charlotte Street, and across from Charlotte Street, the Supreme Court building on Charlotte Street is the City Council, the Engineers Building, City Engineers Building, the City Hall Complex, and the City Engineers Building. And this brings us to the Avenue of the Republic. So Charlotte Street ends at the Avenue of the Republic, at this western end. And we've seen parts of Avenue of the Republic before, but across the street is the Land Registry. That's Avenue of the Republic looking north on a Sunday afternoon, and at the end, the top end, the north end of this section is the National Library. So that's the National Library building and the Tower, Hotel Tower,
the Bank of Guyana building at the north end of Avenue of the Republic. We're still at Charlotte Street. Not looking back at Charlotte Street. Supreme Court building, Charlotte Street and Avenue of the Republic, looking south. Oh well, say hi.
Hello.
Say hi to my subscribers in New York and London and Toronto.
Hi.
What's your name?
Raquel.
Pardon?
Raquel.
Raquel, say hi to London.
Oh, hi London. Welcome to Guyana.
All right, and come back. Come back and visit us.
Okay.
So there you have it. That's Charlotte Street in 2017. If you've noticed changes, tell us what they are in the comments below. If you want to see more content like this, as usual, click like and subscribe. Share this video on other social media platforms.